What's going on?
The data stream is corrupted. No, scratch that. This says it's incomplete. It's the Codex pages. It looks like Ezio had them all when this memory occurred.
Great. And how am I supposed to find them?
Hold on. It looks like Ezio has a map on him. He must have picked it up during one of the corrupted sequences. According to this, it'll show you the location of any missing Codex pages.
Great metal work here.
Do you require your medical escort?
Do come again.
Let their mercy not in vain. You have our hearts and sometimes more. Ever grateful for your
fame.
This hero's luck will hold, we pray. And when he plays his cards, he'll root out all the evildoers and then take out the guards.
To be avoided, and violators will be punished.
This mighty man, he keeps the poor from the mighty's reach. He keeps the famous hope and more. His lips, they do beseech.
Are to be excluded from all
keep away.
However, Justitia, Justitia, in your name comes he this day. Dance and sing till God falls down.
All right, go.
Oh, guardate. Che zucche.
Che pompe.
By decree of the Council of Ten, all cittadini which
is the
part...
Did you mind from making all this working quite
before? The merchant Medardo of San Polo has been found guilty of treason against the Serene Republic.
Leonardo!
Ezio, so good to see you. How can I help you?
Ha ha! You found another one! How exciting!
I see. If I just rearrange these letters... Here, it's done.
Ezio!
It is time, uncle. Let us finish what you and my father started all those years ago.
Indeed. Perhaps now we can finally make sense of this prophecy and put a stop to whatever it is the Spaniard is plotting.
We should start by locating the vault. The Codex pages will lead us to it. Let's take a look.
Rodrigo Borgia, aka the Spaniard. A dark stain on human history, Rodrigo left a trail of blood a mile wide on his quest to unify Italy under the Templar banner. Anyone who opposed him ended up in little pieces inside a sack, or, if he was in a good mood, poisoned. Once he was crowned Pope, Rodrigo, or should I say Alexander VI, used his influence to wage war with any city that held out against the Templars. And then there were the rumored X-rated atrocities. Hundreds of courtesans brought to the Vatican by the cartload, and the Pope's close friendship with his illegitimate daughter, Lucrezia. Oh yeah, and did I mention the killings never stopped? Throughout all his public debauchery, Rodrigo was quietly murdering his enemies behind the scenes, consolidating Templar power for the moment when they would seize control.
is a map of the entire world. But there are lands shown here that do not exist.
Apparently they do exist. I imagine they've yet to be discovered. Or rediscovered.
How is this possible?
Perhaps the vault will hold the answer.
Do you see where it is, then?
No. It can't be. The vault. It looks like the vault is in Roma, then the Spaniard. This is why he became Pope.
Now I understand. It's not the vault alone he's gained access to, but the staff as well.
What staff?
The Codex always spoke of two keys. Two pieces of Eden needed to open the vault. One is the apple.
And the other is the staff. The papal staff is the second piece of Eden.
For years, no, decades, we've sought these answers.
And now, at last, we have them.
But so too could the Spaniard. And if he does, if he finds a way into the vault, its contents will make the apple seem a trifling thing.
I must go to Roma and find the vault. What are the rest of you?
We'll do what we do best. Cause some trouble in the city, giving you the freedom to conduct your search.
Just let me know when you are ready, Nipote. Roma beckons, Ezio. Let me know when you are ready to depart.
antidote! Credo in unum Deum Patrem Omnipotentem, Factorem Celi et Terrae, Visibilium Omnium et... et in unum dominum Jesum Christum, filium Dei unigenitum, et ex patre natum ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo, lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo verum. Genitum non factum consubstantiarem patri, perquem omnia facta sunt, qui propter nos homines et propter nostram salutem descendit.
I thought I was beyond this, but I'm not. I've waited too long, lost too much. Requiescat in pace, you bastard.
I don't think so. No! How is it you resist? I see. Kind of you to bring me the apple. Now give it here!
Vai a farti fottere.
Always the fighter, just like your father. Well, rejoice, my child, for you will see him again soon. You will give it to me.
As you wish.
Fascinating. An impressive power, this. But if you think it's going to save you, another thing coming! You cannot stop me! Useless. You are right to fear me. Not take this from me.
It's finished, Rodrigo. Lay down your arms, and I will make sure the end comes swiftly.
Really, Ezio? And would you give up so easily were it the other way around? Why don't we find out?
Deal with you.
open, damn you! Open!
It's over, Rodrigo. No more tricks. No more ancient artifacts. No more weapons. Let us see what you are made of, old man.
All right, then. If that's how you want to play it.
What do you even want with the vault, Rodrigo?
Don't you know what lies within? Or do you mean to tell me the great and powerful assassins didn't figure it out?
Figure what out?
God. It's God that dwells within.
You expect me to believe that God lives beneath Il Vaticano?
A more logical location than a kingdom in a cloud, don't you think? Surrounded by singing angels and cherubim, makes for a lovely image. But the truth is far more interesting.
Let's say I was to believe you. What do you think he'll do when you open that door?
I don't care. It's not approval I'm after. Just power.
And you think he'll give it up?
Whatever lies beyond that wall won't be able to resist the staff and apple. They were made for felling gods.
God is meant to be all-knowing, all-powerful. You think a couple of ancient relics can harm him?
You know nothing, boy. You take your image of the creators from an ancient book. A book, mind you, written by men.
You are the Pope, and yet you dismiss the central text of your faith?
Are you so naive? I became Pope because it gave me access. It gave me power. Do you think I believe a single goddamn word of that ridiculous book? It's all lies and superstition. Just like every other religious tract written over the past 10,000 years.
In pace.
Greetings, Prophet. It is good you have come. Let us see it, to give thanks. We must speak.
Who are you?
Many names. When I died, it was Minerva. Before that, Mulva and Mera, and on. The others, too. Juno, who was before called Uni. Jupiter, who was before called Tinia.
You are gods.
No, not gods. We simply came before. Even when we walked the world, your kind struggled to understand our existence. We were more advanced in time. Your minds were not yet ready. Still not. Maybe never. No matter. You may not comprehend us, but you will comprehend our warning. You must.
None of what you are saying makes sense.
Our words are not meant for you.
What are you talking about? There's no one else here.
Enough. I do not wish to speak with you, but through you. You are the prophet. You've played your part. You anger him, but please be silent, that we may commune. Listen. When we were still flesh and our home still whole, your kind betrayed us. We who made you. We who gave you life. We were strong, but you were many, and both of us craved war. So busy were we with earthly concerns, we failed to notice the heavens. And by the time we did, the world burned until naught remained but ash. It should have ended then and there. But we built you in our own image. We built you to survive. And so we did. Few were our numbers. Your kind and mine. It took sacrifice, strength, compassion. But we rebuilt. And as life returned to the world, we endeavored to ensure this tragedy would not be repeated. But now, we are dying, and time will work against us. Truth turned into myth and legend. What we built, misunderstood. Let my words preserve the message and make a record of our loss. But let my words also bring hope. You must find the other temples, built by those who knew to turn away from war. They worked to protect us, to save us from the fire. If you can find them, if their work can be saved, so too might this world. Be quick, for time grows short, and guard against the cross, for there are many who will stand in your way. It is done. The message is delivered. We are gone now from this world. All of us. We can do no more. The rest is up to you, Desmond.
What? Who is Desmond? I don't understand. Please, wait. I have so many questions.
There's only about 10 minutes until I
get... Need all of my equipment.
Ready to go before they do. Desmond!
Yeah.
All right, Sean, I need you and Rebecca to get everything in here packed up and loaded into the truck. You and I'll deal with the Templars.
What, they're here?
It was only a matter of time before they discovered us. To be honest, I'm surprised it took them as long as it did.
Let's go!
So, what's the plan? We ditch this place, and then what?
There's another safe house. We've got company. The truck's just up ahead.
Mr. Miles,
This is an unexpectedly pleasant turn of events. And here I thought I'd have to waste more men on you. Kind of you to save me the trouble.
What do you want, Vidic?
For you to come home. We miss you terribly. There's still so much work for us to do together.
It's not happening, Warren.
You continue to disappoint in every conceivable way, Miss Stillman. I saved your life once. Do you remember? And this is how you repay me?
You saved me so you could keep experimenting on people, destroying their lives. And for what?
This tired argument again. As I recall, you were there, at my side, every step of the way. Their blood is on your hands just as much as mine.
You need to stop him.
I'm on it.
Doc, looks like it's just you and me now.
Enjoy your victory, Mr. Miles. Temporary as it is.
Desmond, we have to go!
There you are, come on! Help Lucy into the van! Hurry, Desmond, we need to go!
You'll have your turn, Desmond. Warren's gonna get what he deserves. I promise.
So what now? Where are we headed?
There's a cabin up north. We should be safe there. At least for a little while. I have to analyze those tapes from your session. Figure out what's happening.
And then what?
Here we go. I've got you all hooked up. Got a long drive ahead of us. Figured you might want to play around with the Animus on the way.
All right, but I got some questions first. I mean, what the hell was that in the vault?
What you saw proves everything I was afraid of. The Templars aren't our biggest threat. Not by a long shot.
So what, the sun is? What's it gonna do, cook the Earth?
I doubt it, but I don't know. There's been some speculation that the Earth's magnetic field is weakening. A sufficiently strong flare could flip the poles and cause a geomagnetic reversal. It's all theoretical, but if it happens, the planet could become geologically unstable. Very unstable.
It's meant to be the stuff of pseudoscience, but clearly something catastrophic happened to the people of the first civilization. Minerva, was it? She seemed to think we were due for a second round.
So either way, we're fucked.
I don't know yet. We'll keep reviewing the tapes. And you can keep digging through your memories. Maybe there's more to discover.
All right. Guess I better get started.